Hi guys, and welcome back to SiteEng, where you can see all interesting engineering, civil engineering, site engineering stuff. And in today's video, guys, we're going to try jump on top of the deck if it's ready for us. And I'm going to show you how to market and all the stuff you need to know to just be ready for it. And obviously later we're going to have a look at the drawing, and we're going to make sure we got all the information here. We're going to put it on the instrument, and there we go. So just before we go, guys, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, follow my LinkedIn page as well, and check my Ko-fi page also. So let's go. So guys, a few people ask me just how to set the laser, how to do it. I thought I explained on the previous video, but before we're going to jump on top, I show you this, guys. You see the carry-on with the deck in there, and I got the laser here. So I turn it on. And what we're gonna do, guys, obviously we're gonna look for the height of the laser first. So that's the height of collimation. So guys, you see the laser, to put the datum before using the survey. So datum gonna be your level here. Whatever level you're gonna be doing, you have to put your datums using the survey program. You can check this on my videos covering the setting out series. And actually I recommend you to jump on my setting out leveling video when I'm gonna covering the laser. Difference between your datum and that laser here. So that distance you're gonna measure with the tape. Once you got your height of collimation, obviously that's what I covered in last video, we got a soffit level and we know our build up, and that's what we're gonna be setting on the staff. So we're gonna put then later we're gonna put the receiver on the staff, and guys gonna be ready to go. I just maybe quickly show you how they check it later. I call it datum, obviously whatever level you're gonna be doing, wherever you're gonna be, you need to set your EDM first once the column ready, once the columns are done, and then you're gonna be setting datums, and the more datums you're gonna set, the better for you, the easier. As you can see, it's quite dense here now, so if you're gonna set your laser behind that column, you will not see this datum here. So I would recommend obviously put some datums on the core, on each side of the core, and then maybe a few perimeter columns to make your life easy, guys. So yeah, I just quickly show you when they're gonna be leveling this, and we're jumping up, let's go. Look at this, guys. People who will be living here, they're gonna have a nice view here. But anyway, let's go back to the game.
I'd like to show you how to mark the deck in here, but look, chip is still working. They're not ready yet. So I'm gonna show you just on this bit here, but as you can see, they finishing off. They actually installing the combi save there. So once it's saved, you can go there, and you're allowed to go there. But if there are any steps to be marked, sometimes they need to be marked before you jump in there. So you need to give your prism, maybe even to Chippy, or set up your EDM so you can shoot the laser and show the Chippy where the step is, or give him some line, offset line, and let him measure. So guys, unfortunately we're not going to jump on the deck today, but I'm going to show you how to set up your instrument. We're going to have a look at the drawing, at the most important information, what we're going to be actually marking. I'm going to show you the drawing later, and now I'm going to show you just a few lines here, and I'm going to jump on other drawings when I had more time to have a look, so you can have a look, guys, as well, what to mark and what information is needed once you jump on the deck. So let's go.
Just to show you when the decking is ready, and I showed you everything you're going to be marking, we're using a survey board, we're using monopod like this to set the EDM. Obviously you cannot set up your EDM on the decking, as that's going to be moving. You cannot just do it. Decking is not a stable surface, so you need something like this, and then you set up your EDM on it. As you can see, the level there, that can only guarantee the smallest error. So when you're pouring the columns, you need to install a pipe like this. Always, guys, if you got a chance, if you don't need to use it, actually it is even better than the monopole here. You can set your legs like this on the core walls or wherever. That's the setup. It looks a little bit dodgy, but it's a good way anyway. It's, as you have to remember, on a monopod it's always you're gonna have some movement and the accuracy gonna be less. So I would say this is a better setup if you can do so. Obviously if you got the core there, port, and no movements.
So guys, as I showed you, that's the survey board for the instrument here, and you're gonna be setting out the lines here and all the boxes, everything, the balconies, obviously the lines for the balconies, all the stuff. So I'm checking myself now. But that will be your job when the deck is open. Obviously, as soon as you can get in, you're going to be marking all this. You're going to be marking the boxes, obviously. Everything is on the GA. And obviously, later I'm going to jump on the GA drawing and I'm going to show you everything. So you're going to see what I'm talking about. This is the... So the precast already in here. We got the boxes, as I said. So that will be the main job, guys, just to set the slab edges, really. That can give a start for the fixers and start for the chippies to install the balcony connectors and all these things, and then boxes and boxes again,
The most important thing not to miss anything here, guys. And obviously you can, once your EDM is here, you can do the spot check of the level here of your decking as well, as this is going to be your soffit, especially when something is sitting on it, that should be the proper level. So you see, you can do some spot checks as well with the EDM.
And obviously, guys, after you mark your decking, before we pour, guys, that's the last chance of do the pre-pour. Just go have a look. And in terms of checking the steel, you can see my video about the rebar checking, the pre-pour video. You should be seeing the link now to this, so you can have a look how I'm doing the pre-pour inspection here. As my main role here was the QA inspections, but as a setting out engineer, obviously once you can set up your EDM there on the previous pour, if you got the concrete, if not, as I said, they're going to be monopod or the tripod, and you can actually shoot this with a laser. You can shoot your slabage, in this case that's going to be shutter, but that shutter going to be your slabage, so you can shoot it, just double check if the position is correct. You can quickly have a look if the boxes are in the position, just count the boxes, how many they are, and all that stuff. That man is happy there. And that will be all, guys. And obviously, just when the concrete coming, your job going to be just to set the laser, and the guy's going to do the rest. As I said, all this cover, all this stuff, that's the rebar pre-pour inspection. You can see on my other video. And then, guys, after this is poured, obviously we're going to have a look. We're going to jump on top, and that's going to be next video when I'm going to show you doing the surveys and marking the columns and all this stuff. So guys, the first drawing I'm going to show you, that's the GE drawing. It's actually the most important drawing for us here doing the setting out and the site engineering on site. Obviously, we're going to have a look at the sections. I show you actually the section on the rebar drawing, and then show you the casting detail as well, as this is very important. But the very first thing, guys, we're going to be doing on the decking, and actually below, as I showed on last video, we try to mark all these steps. So all that dashed line here showing the step in the soffit of the slab. So that's going to be actually the step made by the chippies in the decking. So that's going to be our decking line, is this one here. And the same story here, guys, you can see there's a dashed line here and dashed line here. So that means there's going to be something, and we got it here as a BB. And so we can actually have a quick look in the legend what the BB stands for. So that's the downstand here, downstand beam. 200 wide by 650 deep, so we have to have a look at it. And obviously at these things we need to have a look before we even start doing the decking, and then we're going to be marking it. So that line going to be marked by us once on top of the deck to make a real step in the slab. But obviously that's the time, guys, in my last video, once we're doing the decking, we need to mark it. We need to make sure Chippy knows this. Obviously they got the temporary works drawing, which should correspond to this drawing, but that's the way we want to keep an eye on it. But once we are now on top of the deck, we need to be ready just to mark that line. So obviously on that information, guys, you can find it on my setting out series drawings, how to bring the drawings into the instrument, how to bring the information into the EDM. So I'm not going to be repeating this. Guys on my side, they're using TS16s. So they are bringing all the drawings here, and then they just tap the line and they do a setting out. So that's how it works really here, guys. And then once we got the step, obviously all other information here as well. So that's all boxes here, all these boxes. We need to know position of them. We need to mark them on the deck. And then as you could see before, they were already installed on the decking. So all this, you can see dashed line here. So that some columns dying off. And on this deck, actually, guys, here we got the new columns as well. So once the rebar is set, that will be your another job, just to set the position of new columns, or the new starter bars can be installed. But this is after the rebar is installed, after top mesh is installed, so we can actually mark it on the rebar, and then the fixers can fix the new starter bars. So what we got, guys, in terms of the boxes, actually you got the sizes of the boxes. So what you could see on our deck in here, the boxes are ready made, but sometimes the box is going to be made by chippies. So before you're going to start going on the deck and all this stuff, you can actually check how many boxes you need and what sizes of boxes you need. So for instance, let's take these two boxes. You got 1400 by 200, and the other box is going to be 1275 by 200. So depending on job, I was sometimes doing all list of all the boxes needed for particular slab, for particular pour. I was doing the like list of the boxes needed, so the chippy could actually prepare the boxes if they wasn't ordered ready-made. So yeah, guys, that would be all. So all the information is here in terms of setting out. You need to all mark it and then have a look later and make sure all is in. And in this case, guys, actually that's the part we were actually doing, so the decking was ready. So I'm gonna actually show you the section through here. You see the section 1-1, so you can see the section here.
So that's what I'm saying. So that's your step in the soffit, and that's gonna be later step on top. So that's the line you're gonna be marking here once you're on the decking, and that was the dashed line on the previous drawing. That would be good to have a look at the all sectional information we got, guys, before we go. And I'm gonna show you one more drawing, guys. On this decking, actually, guys, we got a castings as well, and this is the balcony castings and the half end castings as well. So as you can see, you got the all layout here, you got the setting out as well for them, you got the sections showing you the position and the level of the castings. So in this case, we had the balcony brackets, which have to be marked, and the best way to just make sure they're gonna be in the position later is to use a template. But in terms of setting out, you need to make sure they correctly set to the level and to the position. So we got a section here showing the castings. As I said, that's the setting out here. And we got a position of the half ends as well. You can see the height of it. So from the top of the slab, you're 175, 100. These have to be set on that slab edge I was showing you. You could see that actually when I was telling about shooting your shutter to make sure your slab edge is in correct position. So you can actually have a look there. You can see some of them already installed. So that's the information we need, guys, on this deck. So obviously, guys, if you got any questions, just please don't forget to leave some comments, let me know, and I'm going to reply as soon as possible. But I think that will be all actually information needed for this deck. Obviously, guys, once you got these drawings, you need time to have a look at it to make sure you know everything. If you got any questions, go to your senior engineer, to your project engineer, and just to make sure everything is clear and all information can be then transferred to site, to your chippy foreman and to all the chippies. So all work going to be done as required as per drawings. So hey, guys, I think that will be all the information I would like to show you in this video about the drawings. And then next video we're gonna jump on top.
So guys, that will be all in today's video about the marking the deck and all this stuff, guys. And in the next video after the pour, we're gonna jump on top of the slab, we're gonna do the survey, and we're gonna start marking column and start getting ready for the next slab. So guys, thank you again for watching. If you enjoyed it, just leave the thumbs up, leave some comments if you got any questions, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, follow my LinkedIn page, and then check my Ko-fi page as well. So yeah, guys, thank you again, and see you next time.